Good morning, students. Today I have brought with the last topics of chapter 2 history. With this we are going to discuss after the Marathas war that how do the claim of paramountcy and what are the challenges being faced during the after the paramountcy rule which has been introduced by the Britishers. Okay, in this we have been understood that in the early 19th century the company jo East India Company thi, they have pursued an aggressive policy of territory expansion, trade and territory. This the chapter is all about. So apni territory ko expansion ke liye unhone bahut sare aggressively or in a very challenging policies and rules introduce kiye. Why they have introduced such rules? So that they can expand their territory system, they can expand and rule over India. In this they have some of the policies been introduced in British, then in during the Mysore war or Marathas, the war taken places, that time some of the policies has been worked out through which the rule policy through which the territory system has been affected, and they introduce or they expand the ruling their ruling over the territory system. Okay, Lord Hastings. Now the policy of paramountcy has been introduced. In this, Lord Hastings, Governor General in 1813 to 1823, he was the Governor General during 1813 to 1823. Before this, the first Governor General who was there, you will comment me under the video. Okay, the Lord Hastings, he was the one who have introduced this policy. In this policy, what he has claimed that whose power will be the supreme, that will rule the other territory regions. Okay, so this was all about that the company claimed that the authority was paramount or supreme. Jo अथॉरिटी जिसकी अथॉरिटी सुप्रीम होगी या पैरामाउंट मीन्स सुप्रीम होना पावर हाई पावर होगी दे आर गोइंग टू रूल ओवर द अदर टेरिटोरियल रीजन एंड दे सॉ दैट द ब्रिटिश और इंडियन ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी हैविंग द मोर पावर एज कंपेयर टू द इंडियन रीजन सो दे आर गोइंग टू रूल बट दिस इज नॉट ऑल अबाउट ना लाइक आई सेड दैट आई एम गोइंग टू रूल दिस एरिया सो विल इट विल बी एक्सेप्टेड बाय ऑल नो the those who are ruling or those who are more capable or those whose country is this or whose region is this, they will protest over it, right? But the policy was all about this thing that whose power will be supreme, according to that the person is going to authorize the area. Now the policy continued to process in the expansion. What this policy is all about, that the expansion is going to take place one by one, another and another, the policy expansion will be going to take place. Now however, the process took over the challenges one and the other, second and third. Then what challenges did they face, we are going to discuss over this side. During the Anaxarya period of in the Kittur is a region in Karnataka. Okay, India mein Karnataka hai, wahan ek Kittur region tha. Wahan pe the king of Kittur, there was a queen who was known as Rani Chennamma. Rani Chennamma was the one who protested against the East India Company. Why she has protested? She has protested against Britishers so that they do not increase their territory, they do not come in their territorial region, that is Kittur. Okay, for that Rani Chennamma took armed British force, they have took the arms, the troops, and then they put out a policy which is known as British Resistance Movement. This was a movement which was introduced by Rani Chennamma. After this, when she have introduced this, obviously Britishers were powerful, so they arrested Rani Chennamma and put into a prison. In which year? In 1826. Okay, when she was being arrested and put in the prison, there she is being died. Okay, in 1826 she was being arrested, and after that she died in the prison only. After that, when she took a very strong motive, strong movement in front of the Britishers. But so that movement was being further taken by whom? By Rayanna. Okay, Rayanna was a poor chowkidar, a watchman or a chowkidar who is being taking care, a security guard who was Rayanna. He has regulated a particular area. He has carried out that resistance policy of Britishers against the Britishers resistance movement, and further he was also been caught in 1850. Okay, in 1850 by the Britishers he was also been caught and hanged out. Okay, and then he also died. Similarly, this movement moved further. Now where did it move will take place, we will discuss that. Okay, so now we are coming over this topic that at how the East, now here we have understood that he was being caught, who was being called? Rayanna was being caught, right? Now what happened? After this, Britishers thought that why not to conquer over the Northwest area. For Northwest area, what they have done, why they want to conquer the Northwest area? Because they were very much worried with the Russia. An expansion. जो रशिया था वो भी एक्सपैंड कर रहा था, वो भी इंडिया के नॉर्थ वेस्ट एरिया में, सॉरी नॉर्थ वेस्ट एरिया की तरफ आ रहा था. इंडिया जो था वो पूरा कंबाइंड था, पाकिस्तान और यह कंबाइंड नहीं थी उस टाइम पे जब ब्रिटिशर्स रूल कर रहे थे, राइट? सो एट दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम द रशियन एक्सपेंशन वॉज देयर एंड दे वॉन्टेड दैट वाई नॉट द ड्यू टू देयर एक्सपेंशन दे डू नॉट कॉन्कर द इंडिया, दे डू नॉट रिमूव अस, दे वर वेरी वरीड. ओके, द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी वॉज वेरी वरीड अबाउट इट. देन एशियन दे एंटर द इंडिया फ्रॉम द नॉर्थ वेस्ट. दे स्टार्ट फाइटिंग विद द अफगानिस्तान बिकॉज दे वॉन्ट दैट दे डू नॉट कॉन्कर ओवर द इंडिया from the northwest area. Okay, now the Britishers wanted to secure themselves, right? They know that the Russians going to come, so they want to secure their own self, and for that they have been prolonged over the war. They have been fighting over a particular war area for a longer period of a time, which was between 1838 to 1842. Okay, this was a time period where they were being Afghanistan from with Afghanistan they start fighting. Now they want to take over the Sindh, the Punjab area. For that they have taken it in 1843. Why? Because the Sindh was being ruled by Maharaja Ranjit Singh. He was a very courageous and very strong leader, and in under his territorial ruling the Britishers could not fight with them or win from him. Okay, so at that particular time they didn't did anything. They waited for his death, which was held in 1839. After that, two prolonged wars were done. Other the territorial areas or other kings who have come after Maharaja Ranjit Singh, They use the divide and rule policy, and then they conquer in 1843 the Sindh area, the Punjab Sindh area. Okay, next in they've been living over the Punjab, was Punjab Sindh ko conquer karke phir wo Punjab ki taraf move on hue. Further they move over the Punjab area. Okay, and as we know that Punjab was not an easy job for them, but using the clever mind, using the policy, the political stamina and all these techniques, tricks and techniques, they have conquered over the area. Understood? Over the conclusion part. In this conclusion part, we are going to study that as how the East India Company affected it, how they have ruled and territorized. Everything we need to talk about. Hame pata chal gaya ki we have got to know about or that how or the East India Company in India, they do done trade, then they start territorying over the different region. They many wars, many civilians, many freedom fighters, many fighters have fought for their country and consumed this, But now what happened? What are the reasons through which this trading company become a territorial company? How it is ruled over the colonial power? East India Company, a trading company to a territorial colonial power. This we are going to understand. How we are going to understand it? First of all, what the advantage? This is what the main advantage that they have been using to come through first manually. For that, 6 to 7 months took place to come to India, okay, from Britain. Now, the arrival of a new steam engine, when the steam technology, the steam engines have been come out, that, and these using the steam technology, that play a very important role, and it took only 2 to 3 weeks, okay, 2 to 3 weeks they have to play it, and they reach to India. Due to this, they get to more time, more journey has been completed, which has been first taken place in 6 to 8 months, but now it has been the time period has been reduced to 3 weeks. Okay, then by 1857 the company had a vast empire in India. Agar hum dekhe 1857 tak India ke bahut zyada area jo hai, a number of a vast region has been conquered by what? By the company rule. They had been a vast empire in India, has been ruled up by the company. Okay, then what does it affect? If we see that the regional area, then the company excessively directed this rule, and about 63% of the territorial region and 78% of population or the subcontinents of India has been conquered by East India Company. Okay, so we have understood that what are the different steps, what are the different areas. Now this is all the, about the conclusion. You just read the topic once again so that everything get you get about it, knowledge about it, and do the exercise work, which is or the objective types, MCQ, fill in the blanks, true false, each and everything at the end of your chapter. Okay, and I will send you the question answer on Thursday. Thank you and have a nice day.